Hello there, welcome to a second presentation on partial differentiation focusing on the use of tree diagrams in conjunction with the chain rule. Recall that in our previous presentation, we considered a situation where we are in the presence of a function of two variables, z of x, y, where x is given as a function of a single variable t, and the y is also given as a function of a single variable t. And in that case, we're looking at how we could compute the ordinary derivative of z with respect to a single variable t. So in the discussion which followed there, we arrived at the fact that the derivative of z with respect to t, now as the ordinary derivative of z with respect to t, would be the partial derivative of z as a function of two variables with respect to x multiplied by the ordinary derivative of x with respect to t plus the partial derivative of z with respect to y multiplied by the ordinary derivative of y with respect to t. Of course, we arrived at the conclusion that this would actually give us what would interpret as the rate of change of z with respect to t. So now in this presentation, we are now going to sort of extend this to a situation where still we've got a function z of x, y, but x now is given as a function of two variables, let's say r and t. And also on the other hand, y is given as a function of two variables, let's say r, t. Then this will actually need us to focus to be more careful in our use of tree diagrams in order to get the partial derivative of z. Let's say we need to compute the partial derivative of z with respect to t, or we need to compute the partial derivative of z with respect to r. I think in this case now we'll see it's more interesting to use the tree diagram. So what I'm going to do, this is the approach I'm going to follow. Now we're given z function of x, y, and again y, or they say x is a function of r and t, and also y is a function of r and t. So what I'm going to do, actually we're having this in mind, so in order to sort of create a get a way, an organized way of differentiating this. So this is what we're going to do. We're going to put z here as the top, and notice that z is a function of x and a function of y, and then 10 x is a function of r and t, and on the other hand also y is a function of r and t. So now we note that if we were to compute the partial derivative of z with respect to r, we've got to notice that r for z, r appears in this branch and it also appears in that branch. So we're considering this is a tree. Of course, it looks like a tree which is upside down. The z there is the stem, then there's a branch there and a branch there. So this is what we're going to do. To get the partial derivative of z with respect to r, we've got to follow first the path along in the direction of x, which we're going to do the following, and then arrive at r there. And in this branch which follow the direction of y, we'll do the same. We'll part from z, come to y, differentiate equal to y, and then land. And then in each case here in this action here, we'll be computing the partial derivative of z with respect to y. And then this branch here will be computing the partial derivative of y with respect to r. Here similarly, this will be targeting the partial derivative of z with respect to x, and then there, partial derivative of x with respect to r. That's what's going to happen. So now, then, since now we've got the two paths in respect to r organized, so this is what we're going to follow. The partial derivative of z with respect to r now will be the partial derivative of z with respect to x, this part, multiplied by the partial derivative of x with respect to r, which will be taking this part, plus the partial derivative of z with respect to y, which is this part, multiplied by the partial derivative of y with respect to r. So that will give us the partial derivative of z with respect to r. Then on the other hand, if we were to get the partial derivative of z with respect to T would do something very, very similar, which would go as follows. We'll part from Z here via Y and then get to T. And then from this side, we'll also part from Z, go via X, and then get to T. So now our organization now is going to be the following. There, we'll be targeting the partial derivative of Z with respect to Y, which is the same thing as that. And then here, we'll be targeting the partial derivative of Z with respect to X, which is simple, the same thing with that. So we don't need to recalculate this. We've got that already. And then when we come here, now we'll get something new, which is going to be now the partial derivative of X with respect to T. And this side, you'll get the partial derivative of Y with respect to T. And then to give this derivative now, we'll simply do exactly what we did here, but in terms of T. So what we have here now is the partial derivative of Z with respect to X multiplied by the partial derivative of X with respect to T plus the partial derivative of Z with respect to Y multiplied by the partial derivative of Y with respect to T. Then we've got our derivative there. So now what we should be able to do now, we should be able to now extend this to Z of with more than two variables, or omega, something like, let's say, omega of x, y, z, with x, y, z also defined as functions of other variables, maybe two variables or one variable. You should be able to do this using the tree diagram. And normally what you are sometimes asked to do here, you could be given a function z and the expressions x and t in terms of the variables here. Then you could be asked to say, maybe someone says, find the derivative, partial derivative of z with respect to t when, let's say, r is equals to 1 and say t is equals to 2, depending on finding. So what you do, you'd compute this derivative as given here. Then using the expressions of r and t here, you would then evaluate that. Then you simply say now partial derivative of z with respect to t evaluated at r comma t, then with this, in that case, given the values of r, particular values of r, this will give you a numerical value here, then you'll be done. But otherwise, if you're just simply asked to calculate the expressions of partial derivatives, this is what you'll do. But for this one, you'll do this and then evaluate. So now at this stage, I hope you understand what you're supposed to do. Then let's get one example, which is as follows. Let us consider the following function of two variables, which is z x squared plus 4xy minus y squared. Given that x and y are also dependent on other two variables, r and t, and there is x defined as rt, r cos 2t, and y defined as r sine t cubed. So now, our task in this case now, let's say, we want to get the derivatives. This is an example, let's say, in our solution there. Let's say we're asked here to find the derivative, partial derivative of z with respect to r, and also partial derivative of z with respect to t. So what do exactly what you have seen in this tree diagram. You just implement this. So during your exercise, you basically start afresh, draw your tree with two branches there, x, y, and in turn, y, x with two branches r t, y also with two branches r and t. So then immediately we should have clearly what is our variables there. X there is r cos 2t and y is r sine t squared. So obvious, like you've seen before, we have to know that these the derivatives or the partial derivative of these two functions. So let's now get the expression for the partial derivative of z with respect to r. Like we saw before, we said we could follow this path and get partial derivative of z with respect to x multiplied by the partial derivative of x with respect to r plus the partial derivative of z with respect to y multiplied by the partial derivative of y with respect to r. So now what you can do here, immediately now here, what you can do, we can calculate the partial derivatives of x with respect to r, because we know we're going to need that, which is simply going to be cos 2t. And the partial derivative of y with respect to r is going to be sine t squared. We've got that. And on the other hand, we know we're going to need also the partial derivative of x with respect to t. Then we write here partial derivative of x with respect to t. Differentiating this with respect to t, r is a constant. Then we write the derivative as we're going to differentiate cosine. Of cosine, then multiply by the derivative argument is going to be minus 2r sine 2t. And on the other hand, this side, the partial derivative of y with respect to t, that will be, now r is a constant and the argument is t squared, then we're going to get this as 2tr cos t squared. That's what we have. At this stage also, let's have also the expression of partial derivative of z with respect to t, which is going to be partial derivative of z with respect to t equals to partial derivative of z with respect to x multiplied by the partial derivative of x with respect to t plus the partial derivative of z with respect to y multiplied by the partial derivative of y with respect to t. So now already you've got the partial derivatives with respect to r and t. Now we need the partial derivatives of z with respect to x and with respect to y. So what you can do now is to calculate that. We have here z equals to x squared plus 4xy minus y squared. So computing the two partial derivatives, it will be partial derivative of z with respect to x, which will simply give us 2x plus 4y, and partial derivative of z with respect to y, that will give us 4x 2y. That's what we have. So now, to now get these derivatives, you simply need to assemble these derivatives according to this formula. So then let's write the answer here. We'll write partial derivative of z with respect to r. What we need here is the partial derivative of z with respect to x, which is here. Then that will come up as 2x plus 4y, right? By the partial derivative of x with respect to r, which is this, which is simply cos 2t, plus now the partial derivative of 4 z with respect to y, which is this 4x minus 2y multiplied by the partial derivative of y with respect to r sine t squared. That will be done for that derivative. Now for the other derivative, partial derivative of z with respect to t, we know we're going to have the same term here, which is 2x plus 4y. That's what we see in the formula. Multiplied by the partial derivative of x with respect to t, which in this case minus 2r sine t plus 4x 2y multiplied by this partial derivative, which is 2rt cos t squared. That will be the partial. So, like I said before, now these are just expressions of the partial derivatives with respect to two variables r and t. Now, say you are given r equals to 1 and t equals to, say, let's say pi over 2. Now, you can see now we can proceed and evaluate these derivatives for these values and evaluate that and also evaluate these other derivatives. And then what we do here, if we now do something like, let's say, evaluate partial derivative of z with respect to t, when r is equals to 1 and t is equals to pi over 2, definitely this is going to give us a numerical value. That is something which we sometimes are going to be asked to do. So now I hope this example explains what makes you understand what I intended to explain here, which is the use of the tree diagrams for the case where the functions x, y actually depend on more than two variables, in this case r and t, and you can extend this to three variables, and it has to work exactly the same using the tree diagram. So at this stage, I think what is important is that you must sit down now and do some kind of practice to familiarize yourself with this kind of work, and for that, I've got the following exercises for you. So in this case here, you compute all the indicated partial derivatives. So like, for example, for 1 and 2, you're just simply calculating the expressions of these partial derivatives. And the 3 and 4, you calculate the partial the expressions of derivatives and also evaluate given these particular values of, in this case, r and theta, and in this case, x and y. In this case, your function is no longer just a z, but is a p, and there is omega, and there is a u. Otherwise, at that point, I would like to say thank you for listening. My name is Chance Wells Fani Msi.